I had a conversation recently with my 14-year-old daughter over lunch on a daddy-daughter date, and we were just having a conversation and trying to learn about each other. And so I asked Caitlin, if you could change something about people, about the world, about culture, what is something that you would like to change? She thought for a minute and she said, Dad, I think I would change the way people look at the Bible. I said, what do you mean by that? And she said, you know, I don't expect people to see the Bible the way we as conservative Christians see it, as inerrant, inspired, infallible. But I wish that people had more respect for God's Word. I said, okay, let's imagine for a moment you have just ridiculous resources. You have billions of dollars. You're one of the richest women on the planet. How might you use your wealth and your resources to bring about the change that you hope to see? She thought for a moment, and as a 14-year-old, of course, her mind went immediately to social media. And she said, I would probably work with influencers to produce content and reels and posts and to network together in ways that would present the Bible as helpful, as meaningful, and respectful. I said, what else would you do? And her mind went then to things like entertainment, movies, television series. She mentioned maybe some books that she would see, work with an author to produce. We talked longer. We went into the educational system. And she said, you know, I might put my ideas into some of the best curriculum. Not obviously, but just work it into the curriculum slowly and in a way that's hardly perceptible. And start with the preschool ages and the kindergartners and then all the way up through high school and even on the university campus. And then I challenged her to think about the influence of the news. Maybe not to her, but news agencies and the influence that it has on adults. And so we talked about ways she might would work with television stations to produce news stories, to create news stories that they would have to cover. Because their goal is actually to get viewers and to make money. And so they will cover a story if they believe that it will get eyes looking at their content. So we talked about all of those things, came up with a strategy to, over the course of, let's say, 25 years, really influence how our culture looks at the scriptures. And then I flipped the script on her. And I said, let's suppose that someone has an idea that, from our perspective, is more nefarious. Suppose they had an idea that they did not like our country the way it is. They wish it to be more socialistic or even communistic. How might they use her strategy to bring about their goals? And when I said that, her eyes got wide. And she realized that is exactly what has been happening. Through education, through entertainment, through social media, everywhere you look, certain ideologies and ideas have been implanted and spread, and the influence is almost imperceptible until it's taken hold. Take that over 25 years, and what do you have? You have our current reality. But now you know, and now you can watch with discernment, and you can realize that some very powerful people are influencing your worldview, and you may not want to give them that right.